Her life was taken, stolen from her. That's not right. She had dreams, she had goals, she had a future.
Kayla Cuevas, just 16 years old, a talented athlete nicknamed the Bullet.
They named her the Bullet because she was so quick.
Sadly, unable to escape the violence just outside her door. Kayla and her best friend, Nisa Mickens, savagely murdered just blocks from home, September 13th, 2016.
This is where it happened.
And Nisa was found right here.
Attacked with baseball bats and a machete, investigators say. Victims of La Mara Salvatrucha, the gang better known as MS-13.
I miss her every second of the day.
MS-13 is one of the most violent street gangs in the United States. Federal and local officials agree. Designated a transnational criminal organization with roots in Central America, more than 30,000 members worldwide, up to 10,000 in the U.S., and as many as 1,000 on Long Island alone.
We have about 500 identified MS-13 members here in Nassau County. Out of that 500, we have 215 that are active.
How do you identify who is an active member?
The number one is self-admitted. So they'll be all tattooed up, MS-13, I'm self-admitted. They do the signs. When they get arrested, they ask them, are you gang affiliate? Yeah, I'm MS-13.
What is the gang's MO?
Kill, rape, control.
Ruling by fear, victims of their violence and recruitment are often young.
Local law enforcement says the gang first came on their radar in 2010, but they started to see an uptick in gang violence in 2015. According to intelligence, that's when leaders of MS-13 in El Salvador made a concerted effort to grow and establish new branches of the gang, so-called programas, in different pockets of the U.S., including the affluent suburbs of New York City and Long Island.
Why New York is the question. And the answer is that in Suffolk County, at least, there is a large Salvadorian population. There's a large population from the Northern Triangle, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras. There's also a record number of unaccompanied minors coming to Suffolk County during that time.
Since 2014, the U.S. government has placed more than 9,000 unaccompanied minors, undocumented children and teenagers who have crossed into the U.S. without parents or guardians, with sponsors in Long Island communities.
Many of them don't speak English. They don't have money in their pocket. Their parents typically aren't with them. They are seeking a sense of belonging. And MS-13 comes to them and says, hey, we can provide that. But by the way, if you don't join the gang, this is what's going to happen to you. And you know what? We know where your family lives.
You wouldn't believe how bad these people are. These aren't people. These are animals.
Is the immigration rhetoric that we're hearing from the current administration in D.C. helping or hurting your efforts?
Certainly the administration's focus on MS-13 is helpful, both in terms of awareness, resources, and driving the mission. But I think it is also very clear that we need to be sending a message to the immigrant population, the immigrant communities, that we stand with them.
And you don't feel like your community is being used as a political pawn in any way?
As a police commissioner, I stay out of politics. It's not, my job is to serve and protect all the people. It doesn't matter what your political affiliation is, the color of your skin, or your religion. It doesn't matter to me.
Her life is so short.
Rodriguez says she's grateful for the support of the president and New York's governor, who recently allocated more than $18 million for gang violence prevention and intervention programs. And she wants to be part of the solution to a safer community, whatever it takes, to prevent another family's pain.
I just want them to stop what they're doing. You're hurting family members, loved ones. In the end result, you're hurting yourself.
Another thing we've learned about these MS-13 gang members, they're overwhelmingly male and they're young, some as young as 15 years old, committing their first violent act. So what can be done? I want to bring in a former MS-13 gang member now working on gang prevention and intervention. Alex Sanchez is the co-founder of Homies Unidos. He's based in Los Angeles, another hotspot for this gang, and he does consulting work on Long Island as well. Alex, so glad to have you with us. Thanks for taking the time. I want to get your personal story first, because you were drawn into this gang as a teenager. You were just 14. What was the appeal?
Well, the appeal was the fact that there were so many social issues in the community that didn't have the answers for the problems that I had. And I decided to look for answers outside of home, because at home there was a lot of abuse. I did not know my parents like many of the unaccompanied minors now. I was also an unaccompanied minor in 1979, so I didn't know my parents. It was difficult to reestablish that relationship. I didn't have other family members in the area, and the school did not provide any services for people like me, neither did the community. So it was difficult for me to deal with the bullying, the harassment of other youth, other ethnic groups, as well as other youth of that are Latinos as well. We were targeted, and including by gangs. So for me, it was something that was attractive primarily because it was cultural, it was related to where I was from, El Salvador. And I felt that for the first time I was being acknowledged by this youth, by being part of something, not only the protection, but really providing some of those needs that youth have during those times.
And what I'm hearing sorry, I didn't mean to step on you, but what I'm hearing you say sounds so similar to what we hear from those we've been speaking to as well about why they believe others currently are getting involved with this gang. How did you get out? What was the turning point? What broke through?
Well, people age out, and I was definitely one that learned from my mistakes. I was incarcerated, eventually deported. I became a father during that period, and I wanted to be a father. I didn't want my son to have to go through the same things that I went through. But I was going up against all odds in El Salvador. When I got down there, I had to flee. There was death squads that were trying to kill me just because I had tattoos. So I had to flee. I came back to what I knew. I came back to my family that was here. I came back because of my son, but more importantly, I came back because I needed to live. I wanted to live. And my son became my priority. Mm-hmm. In the process, I was able to also help other youth in the neighborhood. Yeah. And that's how I started getting involved with the organization.